Hello, my name is Vasilis Trionakis, and I am a member of the Parallel Graph Analytics PGX team in Oracle Labs. In this video, I'll give you a high-level introduction to what the graph process is, and I will explain why would you like to use graphs in your data analytics pipeline. This video is actually the first video in a series of tutorials that will deep dive into graph processing with Oracle Labs PGX and Oracle Labs Data Studio. But first, let's start by taking a look at and explaining what a graph is, using the example on the right-hand side of this slide. So a graph, also known as a property graph, contains vertices that are the entities of the graph. So in this example, we have this green and the red vertices. And then it also contains relationships that connect these vertices together, which are called the edges in graph terminology. Then, in order to have more data on your graph, you can also annotate the vertices and the edges with labels that are essentially types for your vertices and edges. So in the example, we have the green vertex being a customer and the red one is an account. And we have an edge that is connecting these two that is of label owns. Additionally, you can add key value properties on both vertices and edges to represent even more data. So in the example, we have the customer having the name Vasilis and the ownership edge has a creation date called since. So the reason why would you like to represent the data, your data as a graph is that very likely they already look like a graph. So in this example, we have this banking application and the data intuitively have vertices that are connected together with edges as in a graph. Another very well-known example is actually the Facebook graph that contains people which are connected together with friendship relationships. So if your data already look like a graph, you might very well model them as a graph, and then you get the benefits of some nice visualization, intuitive representation, and actually very, very nice and very powerful data analysis, as we will see in the following slides. So the key benefit of graphs is actually that you're able to have and traverse multiple relationships together quickly because these are inherent into the graph model. So another important reason why would you like to use graphs is that it is a very emerging and very powerful technology. So according to the Gartner's top 10 data analytics technology trends for 2020, graph analytics is trend number 4. So here I have the excerpt from this report and I have highlighted already two important points. The first is that we can, with graphs, have some business analysis that analyzes increasingly complex questions across structured and unstructured data. So this is very intuitive with graphs. And additionally, graphs are already there, but also it is predicted that the application of graph processing and graph databases will grow at 100% annual rate over the next few years to enable these complicated business analysis. So in other words, graphs are already there and they will increase in popularity. So you do want to have graphs in your data analytics pipeline. So let's now take a closer look at what do we mean by analyzing and modeling data as a graph, starting with modeling. So traditionally, without graphs, you would model your data in the relational model. So in the example on this slide, we have some customers that would typically be a single table and every customer would be one row on that table, in that table. And then you also have accounts that would be another table. Again, every account would have one row in its table. And of course you want to connect this data to each other. So you want to have customers that own account. And you could have, for instance, a customer owns account table that brings this data together. So here in the first row, we see that customer one is the owner of account one. Now, you see, although these relationships are there, they are not inherent in the model. They are not connected together very, very tightly. In contrast, if we represent the same data as a graph, we still have the customers, we still have the accounts, but now we have explicit edges of ownership that are connected the customers to the accounts that they own. So the relationships here become explicit in the graph model. And then once we have this, you can do some very nice and intuitive analysis on top of the data. So for example, let's say that we want to ask for any two customers who are the co-owners of an account that has a balance more than $100. On the traditional model, what we need to do and what would we typically do is that we would find accounts with the correct balance. So let's say account two has $150, so more than 100. Then we would take a look and connect with the customer owns account table in order to see if it has two owners that account, right? And then from this table, we would connect it with the customer table in order to get the customers of that account and extract the data that we want. So you see that we have the data, but we need to manually glue them together. In contrast, again, in the graph, we can start by finding the correct account with the correct balance. But then once we do that, we have already there directly the ownership edges that can give us directly the customers on the other side that own this account. So things become significantly more intuitive and direct. So I do not really want to go into the details of how you represent this query as a code here, but just to give you the idea how more complicated it is in the traditional model, how simpler it is in the new model. We take a look here at the SQL code that gives you the query, and you see that there are like a complex connections in the where clause for bringing the data and gluing the data together. While in contrast, again, with a graph query language, in this case, it's a PDQL, you can very intuitively and very visually ask for the data that you want. So here we have that the customer C1 is the owner of account A, and the customer C2 is also the owner of the same account A. So things become simpler and intuitive. So to summarize, let me give you the graph superpowers all together in a summary slide. So first, as we said, with graphs, we have a simple and intuitive way to model our data, especially if the data already looks like a graph. Then we can do very strong analysis. And because of the way that graphs are, we can very nicely visualize the graph or parts of the graph. Additionally, with graphs, we have some ready-made useful algorithms that are ready to use for analysis. So with a single click with Oracle Labs PGX, you can find with these algorithms important information in your graph data model. Then, as we saw earlier, we can do very nice interactive queries that are expressive, intuitive, and will give you very good performance because the relationships, the edges are there in your graph model. Last but not least, with graphs, we can do some analysis that is not really or is not intuitive at all for the traditional model. So, for example, we have some graph-specific algorithms that can give you how or if any two vertices are connected with any two numbers of connections in between. So with this, I will finish this video tutorial. Stay tuned for our upcoming video tutorials for more details about graphs. And if you're already curious to learn more details and you want to play with graphs, you can already visit our Oracle Labs PGX website. Thank you for your attention.